Hi, welcome to the session on CMA part 2, strategic financial management. In this session, we'll be discussing about solvency analysis. Solvency analysis talks about the capital structure and its impact on profits, the leverage, etc. So, solvency analysis, in which you need to concentrate on long-term obligations, that whether the business is in a position to pay its long-term obligations on time or not. We discussed about liquidity analysis, in which how the short-term obligations are paid from current assets. This is what we learned in short-term financial analysis or liquidity analysis. Whereas capital structure analysis or solvency analysis talks about what is the status of the business in paying the long-term obligations on time. That how effectively our business is doing, whether we are able to sell the inventory on time, collect the money on time, paying current liabilities on time, also paying the amounts or long-term loans, etc. on time. In solvency analysis, we discussed about the long-term items, which include bank loans, bonds, and debentures. How the money raised from these is utilized in the equation of the total assets. So what is the relationship between the debt capital and equity? How the total assets are contributed, where the assets are contributed from? So for this, what you need to concentrate on is the balance sheet. In balance sheet, you have debt capital, which includes current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Then shareholders' equity. Then the other side, we have total assets. So we are going to study the relationship between the total debt capital and total assets, the relationship between total debt capital and equity capital, also the relationship between the long-term debt and shareholders' equity. Current liabilities and long-term liabilities, we call it as debt capital. How much this amount is invested in the total assets? What is the relation? And what is the capital structure, which is debt capital and, you know, equity capital invested in the business in the equation of the total assets? As you know that we are using some standard financial statements in every analysis. The same statement we'll use in this analysis as well, income statement and a balance sheet. Just reinstate the 2 points. One is on the liability side, you have debt capital, which includes both current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Then equity capital, the total of the equity. In other words, super six. So a debt capital and equity capital on the total assets. Let's work on the ratios. The first ratio talks about how the debt capital is used in the total, in the equation of total assets. It's nothing but debt ratio or debt to total asset ratio. Debt ratio or the debt to total asset ratio. Here, debt ratio or debt to total asset ratio explains the relationship between the total debt capital on the total of the assets. Okay, so it is simply debt to total assets. Debt is nothing but current liabilities and long-term liabilities.
This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, so debt capital is nothing but the total of current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Current liabilities and long-term liabilities in terms of the total assets. Let us see here, current liabilities and long-term liabilities in terms of the total assets. You can see here, current liabilities 175,000 plus long-term liabilities 450,000 is used for the acquisition of the total assets 1,680,000. Let's use the formula, debt ratio or total debt to asset ratio equals to total debt divided by total assets. Total debt include current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Total assets include current assets and fixed assets. How much is contributed? How much of the total asset is contributed? We know the total asset is 1,680,000 and the total liability is 625. So when you calculate the debt ratio, 6,250,000 or 625,000 divided by 1,680,000 is 37.2% or 0.37. So it means that from the total of 100, 37.2% is contributed by debt capital, borrowed money, debt capital. So easily you can see that the remaining portion is owner's money, that is equity. The equity portion is, we can say, 62.8, the remaining. We can say that our money is more in the total of the assets as compared to others' money. It's a good sign, in fact, because the external money invested in the total assets is only, for every $1, it is 0.372. In other words, it is 37.2%. So we have some grip on the business. Why? Because our money is 62.8%. The owner's investment is 62.8% against the others, what they invested in the total assets of the business, which is nothing but debt capital. So you don't have any kind of, you know, the problems from the external funding because it is only a 37.2%. The next ratio is the debt to capital ratio or debt to equity ratio. Debt to capital ratio or debt to capital ratio talks about what is a total debt capital and what is a total capital. In fact, total capital include debt capital plus equity capital. So debt amount in terms of the total capital of the firm. Debt amount in terms of the total capital of the firm is explained by debt to capital ratio. Means what, in the total of the debt and capital, how much is the portion of debt? So it is calculated with the help of a formula called current liabilities plus long-term liabilities divided by total liabilities plus total equity. Your current liabilities plus long-term liabilities is 175,000 plus 450,000, 625,000 divided by total current liabilities, long-term liabilities and the shareholder's equity, which is again 37.2%. So in other words, we can say debt to total asset ratio is equivalent to debt to capital ratio. Debt to total asset ratio equals to debt to capital ratio, because total liabilities and total equity remain same here. 1,680,000, 1,680,000. You get the same answer. So better to calculate always debt to total asset ratio in a meaningful manner. It explains us that how much of the total assets contributed from debt capital. The other ratio explains the relationship between debt to equity, debt and equity. So in a balance sheet, you see here current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Current liabilities and long-term liabilities are called debt capital. And you have equity, which is nothing but super six, your six items. So we are now discussing about how much of debt in terms of equity is invested in the business, raised in the business to acquire the assets. It explains the relationship between debt and equity. Debt and equity. So the formula is so simple. Debt to equity or debt over equity. The total liabilities, current liabilities and long-term liabilities divided by total equity. So let's calculate here. Total liabilities, current liabilities plus long-term liabilities, that is 625,000 divided by total equity, that is 1,055,000. So the debt portion in terms of equity is 59. So if owner's money is $1,000, $590 is borrowed money. So 590 over 1000, 59%. Okay, so debt to equity ratio of above 50% shows us that, you know, it is little bit over financed by external debt. But in this, again, debt is of combination of two, current liability and long-term liability. A current liability is a spontaneous liability. It goes on, you know, up and down on regular basis. It is in fact a friendly loan, we can say. So like accounts payable, accrued expenses and all can be managed. But long-term loans, we have lots of, you know, restrictions while raising the loans, while repayment, etc. Therefore, we need to take care of this amount first, which is explained by a long-term debt to equity ratio, which explains the relationship between the long-term debt and, you know, the equity. You see, long-term debt, we are only considering long-term debts here, eliminating current liabilities. So total debt minus current liabilities divided by total equity. Let's pull out the information from the balance sheet. What is the total long-term debt? You can see here, long-term debt is 450,000 divided by total equity, 1,050,000. So below 40% is okay here. Here it is 42.7%. If you have a 40% or less than that, it is okay. Long-term debts have lots of terms and conditions the company will have to follow. Then one of the important ratios where a company is maintaining good debt portions in terms of equity or not is explained by times interest earned. Very important from examination point of view. Times interest earned ratio is also called as interest coverage ratio. Interest coverage ratio. Interest coverage ratio tells us that how many times of interest you earned in EBIT. How many times of interest you earned in EBIT. So if you see in the income statement, you have components like EBIT minus interest, EBIT minus tax, net income. So your EBIT will be reduced by interest expense before you pay tax. So you get EBT here and you pay tax. This I is deducted from EBIT, then you pay tax. This is your net income, right? So here, if this interest is expressed in terms of EBIT here, it should be at least 10 times. It should be at least 10 times. Say, for example, your EBIT is $1,000 and your interest is 100. 900 is EBT and tax is, say, for example, 40%, 360. So you take home 640 net income because it is 10 times. But say, for example, it is 5 times. So your interest expense is 100 and EBIT is 500, direct interest of 100, 400, pay a tax of 40%, that is 160.
This conference will now be recorded.
So here, 400 times 40% tax will go 160 as a tax. So you take home only 240. See, here it is 5 times. Here it was 10 times. So EBIT, you need to own more times of interest, which is explained in your times interest earned ratio, EBIT over interest, interest expense, EBIT divided by I. Now let's take this information from our income statement. Our income statement in year 2, you have EBIT of 235,000 and interest expense of 20,000. How many times of interest you earned in EBIT? So preferably it should be greater than 10. More times is more good. Okay, higher the times, the best the income we enjoy in the company. So now concentrate on EBIT and interest. How many types of interest earned in EBIT? That is 235,000 divided by 20,000. It is 11.75 times. It's good, but if you improve it, it is too good. So it means that for every $1 of interest, you are earning $11.75 of EBIT. If you own for every $1 of interest, $15, you are just having a profit before tax of $14. Here, we have a profit before tax of $10.75. So the more times you earn, the best is. Times interest earned explains us that how many times of interest you earned in EBIT. More times is good. Earn more times of interest in EBIT. Some companies may be interested in the earnings to fixed charges ratio. Okay, some fixed charges may be there, like you have certain interest expenses, some principal repayments, etc. The repayment may be a repayment of loan, a repayment of some leases, etc. Whether you have sufficient earnings or not. So your EBIT divided by fixed charges, which include loan repayments, lease payments, etc. So better this ratio should be always greater than 1. Means what? You have sufficient earnings to pay some fixed charges. So the ratio less than 1 indicates that you are not earning good amount to pay certain amounts on leases and the repayment of loans, etc. So here it is 5.59 times. It means that the company is earning good amounts to pay some fixed charges. This is the end of the session on solvency analysis. We'll discuss some more topics in the next coming sessions. Till then, have a good time. See you in the next session.